Hey guys, welcome back to another graphic design tutorial. In this tutorial, we're going to learn how to create some amazing text effect design using Kittle Design Platform. We have created these three amazing text effect design using very simple techniques. So Kittle is a design platform where you got a collection of templates for logos, poster, devils, t-shirts and everything. Here are some of the designs. If you go into t-shirt, let's say you want to see some templates, you can see you got some amazing t-shirt designs, and these designs are professionally designed. If you want to recreate this, it takes some time, so you can just go in there and it is easily customizable. You can change the photo, text and everything. With that, it got some amazing tools which I'm going to use it to create my text effects. You got mockup and lots more AI attributes. In this tutorial, I'm going to show you how to create this design. We'll understand how to use their tool and create some amazing text effects from scratch, and it's very simple. So let's begin with our designing process. So first of all, I'll create a new artboard. Just go over here and create a new account, and after that just click on new project, and this will create our new project. And under this you can choose the artboard size. Here we got a collection of artboard sizes. You got social media artboard size, marketing, business, print on demand. So under social media we got Instagram, marketing. We got some logos, poster, flyers, and we got these effects. So let's choose the standard 1200 by 200 pixel. Okay, you can adjust the artboard size over here. You can adjust the units. I'll keep it pixel. The resolution, we'll keep it to 72, and the orientation to this, and create. And there we go, we got our new artboard. In the same way, we have created these artboard. If you want to duplicate a new artboard, you can just click, and with the Alt or Option key, press click and drag, and you create under duplicate of the artboard. And each of these artboard are easily like, you can change the different colors. So let's say you want to give different color, click on it and apply it, and there we go, we got that different color over here. If you want to give different color to this, you can choose any color, let's say yellow or bluish tone, and there we go. Over here you find these all these attributes. We got my project, we got the templates collection here, right? Templates, then we got text, elements, brand kits. You can upload your images or vectors over here. Here we got a collection of images, okay? And after that we got these textures, we got a collection of textures, and here we got Kittle AI where you can generate image, you can generate graphic packs, and you can even generate like editable designs, and all these features are really amazing. But for this tutorial, I want to show you how to create these text effects. So let's see how to create this layer effect, this 3D text effect. So I'll create a duplicate of this, and with the Alt or Option key press okay, and after that I'll just delete all these texts, right? And there we go, we got a blank artboard, and we have changed the color to black, okay? And now let's type out our text. So with the text tool pressed, let's type B-O-L-D bold, and let's change the color to white, okay? Just to see it and increase the size. So with the corner press, from the corner, drag it up, and you can increase the size, okay? Something like that. And let's choose a nice font for this. So let's see which font we have used. We have used the font Forta. So let's choose as font. So selecting this, you got this text over here, and we got a collection of fonts from here, and all these fonts are really amazing, very clean. So let's choose a font for our design, Forta. Okay, and this is the font, and there we go, we got that nice font. Now let's apply this effect. So first of all, as you can see, we have given that perspective look, and it has got some layers. So let's create that. So I'm going to first change the perspective of this. So selecting this, let's go to transformation, right? And under transformation, you can do some adjustments over here. You can, all you got all these options, but for this, I want to change the angle. So selecting that angle, right? You can adjust the angular value here. But before you apply that, I want to change the rotation. So just rotate this to around, let's say, okay, around 60 or 45 is on you. So that's 45, okay? And I'll apply the transform and now adjust this value. So you can see, I will reduce it to minus 100, and there we go, we got that nice perspective look similar to that thing like that. And after that, let's start applying these effects. So very simple, we're gonna go to our text shading. So under text shading, you got four options: drop shadow, line shadow, block shadow, and the 3D shadow with details. So I want this third one, block shadow, click on it, and let's increase the offset. So increase it, and let's set it to this angle, perpendicular, and reduce the thickness around this much, and let's change the color to something, okay, dark blue kind. Let's add a little bit more purple look, something like that. Now we'll create a duplicate of it and bring it on top. So with the Alt press click and drag up and place it on the top, Use the arrow keys to adjust. Now I'll change the color. So we'll make it a little bit blue and a little bit brighter. Something like that. Let's see. And we can change the text color to dark, similar to these colors. In the same way, I'll just go over there and change the font color to same color. Okay. Now, instead of duplicating, you can use the layer option. Just click on the layers. Just drag it up. Okay. So this is the font, right? So selecting the layer, right? You can create a duplicate. Use the shortcut command C or control C to copy and control or command V to paste. And it will paste it on top. And just drag it up with the shift pressed. Okay. And let's change the color. So we'll go to shading and here let's change the color to a little bit brighter and we'll change the font color as well to similar to that color. Okay, we'll bring it one more on top. Let's change it to a little bit brighter, something like that. Let's create one more duplicate, change the color to bluish tone, and we'll create one more. Let's change the color to a little bit more brighter, around greenish tone a little bit. Now I'll just place this accordingly. So okay, there we go. Let's change the font color to white and we got that interesting looking text effect there. Select everything, place it around here, scale down the size, and there we go. Now, if you want to give some different color tones to this, you can use the color palette. So if I go over here, you can see we got these colors and we got some browse color palette. You can just click on it and here you can choose from different color palettes. You can just go and let's say you want it like this, or you want to choose some blue or purple. So we got a collection of color swatches which you can use it for your design. I think this looks good, right? Yellowish tone, it looks great, but I like the original one, so I'll keep it that way. Now let's look at our second design. We're gonna use the same technique, right? So I'll just select this and create a duplicate with the Alt or Option key. Okay, and I'll just delete everything. We have set the background color to yellow. Okay, and just remove these layers. Okay, and now let's type text 2 AM. Okay, this is the font. Just increase the font size. Okay, so for this font we have used the font that is Roboto. So selecting that, it's a Roboto. You can choose font size from here. If you want to make it a little thicker, you can apply that, or maybe a little bit of bold. Yep. Now if you see over here, you have given the perspective look. So let's give that perspective look. So we're going to use the transform option again, and we will use this transform option and let's set the angle to around this much. Okay, very simple. Now we'll add that thickness. So I'm going to go to shading and we'll go to block shading and increase the offset value and change the angle to something like this. Reduce the size, make it a little bit thinner, and let's change it to something different color just to see the difference. Now we'll create a duplicate. So either you can go to layers, select text, right? And command control C, command control V, and just move it with the arrow key, just move and place it there. Very easy. And for this, we'll change the color to shading color to different color. Yeah, very simple. Now I'll create a few more, selecting these two layers, command control C, command control V, and let's move. There we go. Place this over here, place it properly. Now we'll create a few more, selecting everything, just click and drag it and arrange it to back. I'll just place it around here. After placing everything, I'll just place it here and I'll just bring out one more copy and place it in the front. There we go. Now you want to change the color, right? You can just select everything and here we got these colors, right? Three colors, black, red and blue. So all these red, we want these colors to be, let's say, yellow. So go to select the red color and choose yellow. And all these blue, I want these to be black. So select black and there we go. We got our text design. Very simple, very easy to create, and that's how we created this nice interesting text effect. Now let's look at how to create this slice effect. And you can see we have created three layers and we have used gradient tool for this. So let's see how to use it. So I'll select this, right? And with the Alt press, click and drag and place it there, right? Now I'll just delete this text, okay? And after, let's type our text, S-L-I-C-E, slice. Selecting the text, let's change the color to white. Let's scale the size. Now over here, let's see. The font we have used is Archivo. So we'll select that and let's choose Archivo text and there we go. Let's set the thickness to around, let's say bold, extra bold. Now let's try to recreate this. So over here, let's go to layers, right? And let's under layer, let's create a duplicate. So command control C, command control V. Okay. Selecting, let's hide the first one, selecting this layer. Let's apply the gradient color. So under color, you can see, just click on it, and here you can choose the gradient colors. You can either choose radial or linear color. So for our slice of fade, I'm going to choose the linear gradient. So click, and this is going to be the top one. So bring in this gradient color and just make it closer to each other, right? And we want this surface to be, let's say it's on the bottom. Okay, I'll just make sure the white surface is a little bit lower and around this much. Okay, so from this slider, I'll just remove the color. So make it, click over here and to remove the color, and just bring it around this much. Let's give it a little bit of angle, something like this. Okay, something like that. Now we'll unhide the second layer. Okay, we'll create a duplicate of it. Okay, Command Control C or Control V, and let's hide the third one. This one, we'll go to our color and let's choose the color again, linear gradient. This time we'll apply two gradient color. So let's apply it, okay, around this much, and we'll apply one around here and one around here, and I just remove the color and bring it to around this much. Okay, and this one, make it a little bit lower and around this much. Okay, now let's set the angle a little bit around this much. We'll select the third one. Okay, and let's unhide the eye and let's give that effect. So go to color again, choose the linear gradient color. So we want white color on top, so I'll just change the angle to from minus to plus 90. Okay, place this on top, remove the fill color from here, and there we go. Now let's adjust the size over here just this much and adjust the angular size. So I'll just make it a little bit around this much. Now we can just individually go into the gradient and adjust the size. Let's adjust the angle a little bit more tilted. Yeah, something like that. You can just play around with the positioning of these slices. And if you want to add these in like gradient look, like the second layer over here. Okay, this one, let's go in there. And under color, I will add some gradient to it. So we'll do, what I will do is we'll add a nice gray color to this. So selecting this color, reduce the opacity of this a little bit just to give that effect. And there we go, we got that nice. Let's make it crispier, reduce the opacity, and that will give you that nice look. And there we go. And that's how you got that nice slice effect. You can just position it. So as you can see, we have used very simple tools and created this interesting text effect design using Kittle Design Platform. I have used the text and I have used all the attributes over here. As you can see, we have used the layer panel. We have chosen a nice font from these font collections. We have used transform option to get these angles and also use the shading option to give these depth. And we have also used this color browser palette where you can choose which color you want to give to your design, and it's very handy. So there we go, we have created these three amazing text effects. Now let's say you want to see this in the real version, how it looks. So we got some mockups for this. So let's say I want to select this and I want to apply to a mockup. So I'll just click on mockup, and here we got a collection of mockups. Let's see how it looks on a notebook. I'll just scale up the size, get back to my editor, and I'll choose different design. I want to apply this design, okay, and to a mockup, to this mobile mockup, and for Instagram, and there it is. You want to apply to a paper, place it there. Let's say you want to place it on the background, on the wall, just scale up the size. On the wall, you'll be able to see that slice effect. Let's see other templates as well. And as you can see, it's easily snap in the perspective, and it got that nice lighting and the texture. It's easily blend with your design. We got some amazing collection of templates for t-shirts, logos, bags, prints, hats. And also if I click one of it, and you can see we got a collection of designs for t-shirts. If I click on logos, we got a collection of design for logos, and each of these designs are easily customizable. The tools are very easy to use, very simple. If you want to check out this platform, I have shared a link in the description, and you can use the promo code CreateInProcessYT and get 25% discount on all Kittle plans for all new users. Create an account and try out these new tools and options. I hope you enjoy this tutorial. Don't forget to check out the next tutorial coming up, and if you want more updates on designing, don't forget to like, share, and subscribe this channel. Thank you.